Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this tutorial, we are going to show you how to create a realistic and real-time reflection surface with JavaScript and 3.js. Let's check it out. First, we are going to create a 3D world using the same technique as our previous video called Skybox. Basically, we will create a cube and put a texture on each side and place the camera at the center. This is the quick and easiest way to create a 3D world. Let's start with the basic setup. We need to import two files, the 3.js core file and orbicontrol.js for the camera control. First, create a scene and set up a camera. Like most tutorial, I'm going to use a perspective camera, using 70 degrees viewing angle and current viewport aspect ratio. I will place the camera mid-air and away from center. Next, set up the renderer. I'll use WebGL renderer and enable anti-aliasing. Set the size to current viewport and append it to the page. And finally, set up orbit camera. For this tutorial, I will disable the zooming. And let's run it to see if there is any errors on the console. If everything goes well, you should see an empty black screen. Now you can download any cube map that you like. For this tutorial, I'll use the interior of St. Peter's Church. And once downloaded, you will get 6 images for each cube side. We'll use the texture loader to load them all. But first, let's create an array to keep the path to the image. Then use cube texture loader and set it as scene background. I will remove the test render and create render loop instead. Next, we will create a sphere shape. To create a 3D object in 3.js, we will need two things: geometry, which defines the physical shape, and material, which defines the surface and texture. Let's create a material. We will use a mesh basic material. The basic material ignores the light so we can see object without setting up any light. Then create a sphere geometry with 350 units radius. The last two are numbers of segments. More segments create more rounded shape at the cost of performance. Then create our shape from the geometry and material. And place it at the center. Now to create a reflection, we'll use a cube camera to capture the scene from all directions, then apply the captured image as texture of the object. First, create a cube camera with 1000 units range. The last number is the resolution. Setting too high will result in frame rate drop. Then place the camera at the same position of the sphere. Then apply the captured image as environment map of the sphere material. Finally, in the render loop, we will need to update the camera using update cube map method. And that's all for this tutorial. You can download the code from our website at the link below. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more dev tips and tutorials. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.